by a score of 67-59. Their ninth meeting since 2005. And here are the champions. Classic Kentucky has beaten Kansas both times they have met. Our officials tonight, Joe DeRosa, Roger Ayers, and Ron Gruber. We are ready for tip of our Sonic blockbuster matchup. And KU, the home team in white, with the first possession of the night.
Kentucky starts out at man-to-man, but I'm telling you, Dan, we're going to see a lot of zone out of Kentucky.
LeGerald Hicks, strong drive and finish.
He's an explosive player, great athlete. He can get to the basket. Very experienced, played a lot of minutes last year.
He sure can. He's an attacker, so I like to say he goes downhill. He went right at the bucket, just 175 pounds, but he plays a tough game.
Well, the big question mark for Kentucky, can they make perimeter shots?
Loaded with freshmen again, the least experienced team John Calipari has ever had, as P.J. Washington, a freshman from Dallas, is fouled and will go to the line. The most experienced player they have coming back is Wenyen Gabriel, who comes off the bench. The second most experienced player they have coming back is Sasha Kalia-Jones, who didn't play last year after January the 21st, and he wasn't hurt.
I'll tell you one thing, though. They got to be the youngest team in America. Yeah. Am I just wondering? I mean, how can they be the youngest? Yeah. Five freshmen starting for them.
And John Calipari, his mindset with this extremely young team right now is be tough on them in practice, really work them, be hard on them in practice, but then give them a pat on the back, give them a little love during games.
Well, he told me before the game, he said, I've been so positive thinking you'd be surprised. I've given them so much love. Hey, let me tell you this, they're not normal freshmen. These are not normal freshmen. Coaches are not crying here at how young they are.
Seven freshmen on this team, ranked in the top 35 of the ESPN 100. Big battle inside between Richards and Azubuki, who doesn't get the ball. Malik Newman, the transfer from Mississippi State, misses the three, but an offensive rebound for the Jayhawks. Svi Mykhailiuk, soft touch off the back of the iron.
Yeah, Mykhailiuk played with the Ukraine national team in the summer. He's a guy that they're really counting on to have a consistent big-time year.
Two-point lead for Kansas in the early going. This is Newman. So sat out last year as a transfer, but was with the team, practiced, knows the system. And Bill Self feels he's maybe thinking a little bit too much right now, maybe trying a little too hard, instead of just letting his natural ability take over. Mykhailiuk, kept alive by Devontae Graham. Mykhailiuk again.
Got two good looks because Graham did a terrific job with the offensive rebound.
Hamidou Diallo, a freak athlete, gives you a little bit of a glimpse of that.
Well, you saw that incredible athletic ability, 6'6". He's got great feel, good first step. He goes the coast to coast, baby.
And he's one guy, Dick. He did join the program in January of last year, but redshirted, but he practiced with the team, so at least he's been in the program for a few months.
Well, a lot of people thought he was going to go to the NBA draft, and I think his status was not as high as he thought.
There's a rejection by Nick Richards, the freshman from Jamaica, but Kentucky turns it over. Kansas is going to get a good look. And Mykhailiuk will bury it.
Can't give him three shots from there. He can make the perimeter shot. That's been one of his keys throughout his career.
You know the amazing thing about him? He's a senior, and he's only 20 years old.
Yeah,
he's a 17-year-old freshman.
Unbelievable. You know, Richards gives them a kind of player like Willie Quillis-Stein, but a little thicker on his body.
Quade Green misses the jumper, freshman from Philadelphia.
I think he's a key player for them. They need great point guard play. Look at that quickness.
Great drive by Newman, but a good recovery and the block for Washington.
You know, Green came out of Philadelphia, highly recruited, point guard. We're going to watch Mykhailiuk get free here. They're going to find him up in the corner, wide open, and he knocks it down. I can make that three. Come on, you kidding me? I can knock that three down, Danny.
No, you are strictly 15 feet ahead at this point, my friend.
10 feet now. Man-to-man defense. I think we're going to see these clubs rotate to the zone.
Kevin Knox, the highest rated of the Kentucky freshmen. He's from Tampa.
He's got talent. Kevin Knox has got a lot of offensive talent.
So does this guy, LeGerald Hicks. KU back on top.
And he's got that energy and enthusiasm. Nobody guarded him. Knox didn't get in his face. That's one area that Kentucky kids are going to have to learn. They're going to play with John Calipari. They're going to have to play on the basketball. Tough.
Green finds the open man. Richards from 17. Too strong. Boy, a frenetic pace. Graham, dump off. Oh, Washington came up with the ball. At least he's cradling it right now. But he's called for the foul.
Washington's a very physical player, very strong. You know, watch this right now. There's a little diagonal pass, dumps it down. Looks like he's got an open layup, and here comes Washington, going to put him on a free throw line.
Washington the foul as he wrapped up Azubuike. Very important guy for Kansas this year. Udoka Azubuike, huge. 7 foot 280 out of Nigeria. Suffered a wrist injury last year. Cost him about the last two-thirds of the season. Kansas really used to have a lot of size inside. They don't have as much. This is a smaller Kansas team than we're accustomed to seeing. Although, again, if and when Billy Preston starts playing, that'll change things.
Well, also, they're expecting to get possibly eligible. We think he's going to graduate high school in mid-year. Silvio D'Souza for IMG Academy. Yep. And they think if he has to get the test score, he'll be eligible to play second semester.
And he's a big guy. Old school four-man is how Bill Self referred to him today. Knox double team. Open man Richards. Washington misses the foul. Ball still loose. Kansas has it. Newman to the bucket.
Malik Newman. Kentucky wanted him badly. He became really, he was John Calipari's guy. He wanted him. He decided to go to Mississippi State, where his dad was all conference when he played there. Didn't work out. And then he transferred and went to Kansas.
Green at the point. He'll share time at the point with Shai Gilgeous-Alexander, who will come off the bench tonight. The lob, oh, and the miss by Richards.
You got to make that. You got to make that. Green does a great job. Little two-man game. Enters the ball. Wow. Got to make that, Dan.
Kansas with a six-point lead. We'll introduce you to one of Kentucky's freshmen, Kevin Knox, when we come back.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by State Farm. Talk to an agent today at 800-STATE-FARM. Gildan, love your dad, but don't wear his underwear. Gildan, every thread counts. And Dollar General, the official discount retailer of the Big 12.
Disney's Star Wars, The Last Jedi. And for more, let's go to Maria Taylor.
The Knox is modeling his game after his KD guys, Kevin Durant, when he showed up. Assistant coach Kenny Payne cut up 35 different clips of KD, and all he wanted Kevin Knox to watch was the way he sets up his shots, what he does before he catches the ball in order to be set and ready to shoot. He wants him to have a quick release and make quick decisions with the ball.
Tell you one thing, Maria, he made a big three late in that game against Vermont that they needed badly.
They had all they could handle from Vermont. Vermont had two shots to tie the game on the three-pointer.
You know, Vermont won 29 games last year. Yep. They were undefeated in a conference. They're probably going to be in the NCAA tournament again. That was a good test for them. Really was.
I thought Jimmy Dykes said it very well. It felt like a 4-13 first-round matchup in the NCAA tournament. Give it a go. Graham takes the bump and he's fouled. Meanwhile, the last foul before we went to timeout was on Svi Mykhailiuk, his second. Remember, Kansas tonight has only 7 scholarship players available for this game, and one of them's got 2 fouls already.
That's a key when you got a veteran player like that sitting.
So Marcus Garrett, a freshman from Dallas, has checked in, number 0 in white.
He's a tenacious player. He's one of those guys that's all the little things coaches want players to do.
He had 10 points and 10 rebounds in Kansas's first game, a win over Tennessee State. Graham the kick. Garrett from the corner. What a rebound by Azubuike, but has it taken away. Sasha Kalia-Jones in off the bench. And with the ball right now, Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. So he had a quad Adrian, 2 freshmen splitting time back and forth at the point right now.
Shai Gilgeous-Alexander's from Canada.
He's from Hamilton, Ontario. That's right. And you and I both wish we had half the hair that he has. Graham in transition. Up and in.
I tell you, I love the unbelievable speed of Graham and Vic. They're going to create a lot of problems for people. Obviously, you know, you miss a guy like Mason and certainly Jackson.
Well, last year, Graham was a great player, but because of Mason, Mason was the lead guy. It's Devontae Graham's team this year. Newman, quick pull-up for three.
He's a big-time scorer at a high school level. Didn't blossom down at Mississippi State. They're expecting great things out of him in a Jayhawk uniform. That was created. Oh, God.
Tomorrow night, NBA doubleheader here on ESPN. Cavs and Hornets in the first game, and Sixers and Lakers in game two. 18-7 Kansas, an early lead over Kentucky. Wenyen Gabriel with an air ball for the baseline. And Hamidou Diallo gets the offensive rebound and is fouled. Such a young Kentucky team. The sophomore in Gabriel, the redshirt freshman in Diallo. Everybody else a true freshman other than Kalia Jones, who played sparingly as a freshman last year. And you can see John Calipari doing a lot of pacing and a lot of gesturing on that sideline.
Well, the one thing they did really well in the victory over Vermont was the free throw line. And that was the difference. It went 18 for 23 on the line. But I'm telling you, they were down 12 against Utah Valley. They were down 12 points and went on an 18-0 run when they went into the 2-3 zone.
Speaking of 2-3 zone, how about Duke playing it for the whole game?
I couldn't believe it. First time I think he's ever done that in his career. Making adjustments. That's why he's one of the greatest of all time.
As a Boogie with a flush.
Having a tough time defensively. Kentucky really right now, the young players having a very difficult time defensively.
They don't have anybody anywhere near the size and strength of Azubuki. Baseline jumper, Gilgeous Alexander, and that'll snap the run for Kansas.
Gives him great size on the perimeter. He had the yellow, a lot of size.
Graham swatted away by Kalia Jones. They do have a lot of length. They figure to block a lot of shots, but they're having so much trouble stopping guard penetration.
You know, I really think with their length and athleticism that the zone fits their team. I think the component of a zone would really work for them well, especially when they got the two big guards out there in Diallo and the kid Alexander.
Mitch Lightfoot into the game for Kansas, so we've now seen all seven available scholarship players for the Jayhawks. A rebound for Richards.
Too much one-on-one right there. Got to get more ball movement. Got to get player movement.
Nice little crossover and finish for Gilgeous Alexander.
I like what I see out of him thus far. But it's been transition where they're beating them off the bounce. Kansas having the advantage.
This group right now, you talked about the length. In the backcourt, they're 6'5", 6'6". And up front, they're 6'9", 6'9", 6'10". They're big. They're long. Lightfoot inside, couldn't finish. And now, discussion about the shot clock. Joe DeRosa says, wait a minute. He thinks the shot clock should have been reset, but that ball hit the rim.
Ball did hit the rim.
Good crew, Joe DeRosa, Roger Ayers, Ron Gruber here handling the second game. They're going to have a look at it.
Hey, what about the first game? And talk about a performance. Grayson Allen showed leadership. He showed dominant performance. Bagley gets hurt early in the first half. Eye injury, takes over and gets 37 big ones.
Now has 77 points through his first three games. Did it hit the rim? It did not.
Oh, it missed. Yeah, it missed. Come on, you got two eyes. I got one. I have an excuse. You don't.
So the officials will see that momentarily.
Well, they got four eyes right now, those two guys.
So right now, the shot clock is showing 8. That's your best look right there. I could just imagine when you were coaching, if they had replay reviews and you had to wait for a minute or two for them to come up with a ball.
Frustrated.
You'd have been crazy on the sideline.
Hey, I'm lucky when I coached, they didn't have the social media and the TV that exists today. I was a wacko on the sideline. Yeah. Trust me, I was, yeah. But I had so much fun.
You don't have to convince me. All right, so shot clock is going to stay at 8 because it did not hit the rim at a Kansas window.
Yeah, Kentucky having a tough time in there, man-to-man. They really are. John's trying to have them be accountable.
Is Bagley signing some autographs? Hopefully the eye injury is not serious. He did not come back into the game, but had a chance to speak with a member of the Duke staff after the game, and they are optimistic that it is not a serious injury.
That was certainly an impressive win for them. You mentioned the Duke staff. Jeff Capel certainly wasn't here. His dad passed. What a great man. Boy, did he know his hoops.
Everything but the finish for Graham, but he gets it back. Yeah, our condolences to the Capel family. Jeff not with the team here tonight after the passing of his father. Travel called on the Jayhawks. Mikhailuk's going to come back into the game with two fouls. And again, this is interesting, but Bill Self's got limited options because Billy Preston, if you weren't with us off the top of the second game, Maria gave you the story. He's not playing again here tonight. He recently was in a single car accident on campus. No injuries, but there is some, I guess, ambiguity about the status of the car, the financial arrangement of the car. They self-reported it. They don't want to play him in case he were to be ineligible. They want to, I guess, for precautionary reasons, hold him out until they find out what the situation is with the car.
Oh, got a layup right here. Got a layup.
Green lays it in.
I like Green. He's a tenacious player. Played well against Vermont, except on the defensive end. He's got to learn to stop the ball. Can't allow penetration. If you don't play the ball tough on top, you create all kinds of problems and a dilemma for the people on the back line.
8-2 run now for Kentucky. Mikhailuk. He's had some good looks tonight. Knocked down one. He's missed a couple others. Gilgeous Alexander's given UK a spark off the bench. He's out there along with Green. Both point guards in there together. Very different players. Green, no. And it'll be a foul on Kentucky to take us to the under 12 media timeout. A great year for Bill Self, inducted into the Naismith Memorial Hall of Fame. More on that when we come back.
Mr. Walton that he had before that. Lou Alcindor, later known as Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Pretty good players, really.
Not bad. But he won with a small item, too. His first national title when he had Goodrich and Hazard. Pretty good memory, huh?
Not bad. What are you, 78?
Oh, come on, Dan. Dan, you room like that. 78. I'm 25. I act about 12. I spoke the other day up in Wichita. And people said, I can't believe that guy's in his 70s.
5-point lead for Kansas over Kentucky here with the nightcap. The second game of the State Farm Champions Classic in front of a packed house at the United Center.
You know, one of the reasons he's not zoning, he has great fear of the three-point shot. John Calipari.
Another offensive rebound, Asabuki. He wants a touch.
He's got to get a little bit scoring inside to get a little balance. That's an area he has to work on. More offensive moves on the interior.
A foul on Nick Richards. Big Blue Nation didn't like that call. That's the second on Richards.
You know, Dan, you think about the Big 12 this year. I was telling Bill before the game, and speaking to him, I think they got a great chance to win it again because I don't think from top to bottom the conference is as strong as it's been in the past. Iowa State certainly struggled. West Virginia's supposed to be really dynamite, yet they got blown out by Texas A&M, who played without two starters. Played without the kid Williams and without the guard Corwell.
What a shot. And Brand to the line as well. But meanwhile, the SEC
is way better.
You might say the opposite. The SEC looks like it's going to have a really good year.
Oh, I think about the SEC. They got some really good clubs, and the Texas A&M is going to be very good. I like what they've done. Missouri is going to be one of the most improved teams in America with Michael Porter Jr. You know, you think about the conference. I think I look at that conference. It's going to be to Alabama with Colin Sexton.
Florida,
we know. Florida's top 10. I just concede that. Kulishev, remember that name. You go on Kulishev, a transfer from Rice. He had 34 for Florida the other night. He could flat out shoot the three. And Mike White's done a terrific job with that program. So picking up the dribbles. No. Picking up the dribble. They have no rhythm offensively. None. Getting familiar with each other. He's going to have a real challenge this year because I'm going to make a statement, and I talked to him about this. And when it's young, we got to give the kids a chance to develop. But I don't think the talent level is what it was last year with De'Aaron Fox, Malik Monk, Adebayo. Those guys were legitimate NBA players.
The most highly rated incoming recruit Kentucky has is Kevin Knox, number 5.
And he's going to assert himself a lot more. He's got a lot of ability and talent.
That's him with the steal.
He can run. Now, get him the ball back. He's got to be a little bit more active and want the ball.
Ty Winyard, no basket. He's going to get called for the push-off.
Well, it's a good call right there. That's definitely a legitimate call. I got one eye, and I can see that, Mr. Schumann. It's great working with you again, buddy.
It's good to see you. Let's see what... I don't know.
You don't think so?
I don't think so.
Wow.
No, I don't think so. I think Kansas got a break.
Yeah, I think they did that too. I'll take that back. You're right. John has got to get Kevin Knox a little bit more.
Oh, wait a minute. It was not. Okay, now we have clarification. It was not on Wynyard. It was on Washington away from the play. So it's the foul on Washington that negates the bucket by Wynyard. Second foul on Washington. So that makes a little bit more sense. So Washington is on the bench with two. And Richards is on the bench with two. And it's Gabriel up front along with Palia Jones and Knox. Again, they're still tall. They're still long. Kevin Calipari's talked about positionless basketball a little bit this year. Less defined roles. Thinking a lot of his players are versatile, can do different things. Palia Jones with a baseline J.
Palia Jones was a big-time scorer in high school. And they need some perimeter shooting. They got to get Knox a little bit more active without the ball. So many of these guys have been used to being the number one option, ball in their hands all the time. Now they got to blend in with other great players, and they have a tough time sometimes making that adjustment.
Another turnover. A couple of sloppy passes by the Jayhawks. Knox for three. Got it.
So they got to get him the ball. He's got great scoring ability. I watched him many a time. I saw video of him. He lived in my area, the Tampa area. Didn't see him in person, but I saw a lot of video. That kid is really talented. I think he's the most talented player they have.
And Kentucky fans making their presence felt right now in Chicago. Newman rejected by Kalia Jones.
Kalia Jones giving him some minutes off the bench, positive minutes. And rotating over the defense. You know, when you wear that uniform, you got to play with pride and passion. That uniform, both those teams, those uniforms represent greatness. They represent a lot of great players. Oh, they missed Asamoah for a layup. He was wide open, Dad.
The Jayhawks have missed eight of their last nine shots. The Gerald Vick is back into the game for KU. Graham for three. Big shot from the senior.
Well, that's what you want out of big shot players. Seniors, veteran players, just like Allen in the first game. Making big plays over the young stars.
Graham's got a chance to have a huge season for Kansas. Knox, you said you wanted him to look for his shot a little bit more.
He's got to want the ball. He's got to want the ball. He's got stardom all over him. They have not seen the real Kevin Knox yet. I've seen this kid can drive with the ball, he can shoot the ball, he can post up.
Kansas running the weave. Vick tries to turn the corner.
Did a better job containing, not letting him get by him. Made him shoot that ball over the top.
Vick runs down his own miss.
Nobody blocked that. As a bookie wants the ball. He got a layup.
They got a dunk.
And a layup, a little dunk city. They got to get some scoring in the post.
Yeah.
Just so you get a little balance. You need balance in life. You need balance in basketball. You need balance in everything you do in life.
Knox looking for his right now. Draws the foul. We'll catch our breath and head to a timeout. 5-point lead for Kansas. Kevin Knox trying to bring UK back. We'll talk about this freshman class of the Wildcats on the other side. Good.
When I'm with you.
Down in Austin, you and I will see the Longhorns against Michigan in a few weeks.
He didn't play today because of a little injury, but he'll be fine. But you know, talking about Ayton, how good is he? I was talking to Roy Williams on the phone recently, and Roy says to me, let me tell you how good he was. We played down in the Bahamas against a Bahama All-Star team when he was 15 years old against my varsity North Carolina team. At 15, he had like 23 and 15. Unbelievable. I can't wait to see him. I'm going to the Atlantis.
Yep.
The Battle of the Atlantis.
Yep.
And Arizona's there. Villanova's there. Purdue is there. Watch Purdue. They're a good team.
Yep. Going to be a great week. Hard to believe it's almost Thanksgiving. That means feast week. That means basketball action wall to wall all over the place.
Kevin Knox needs the one breakout game, and I think you'll see his game just explode. You haven't seen his ability to drive it. I know he can do that.
Kentucky is 2-0 on the young season as Diallo.
Oh, you can't teach that, Danny. You can't teach that, Mr. Schulman. That's explosiveness. Showtime.
You'll be seeing that again with SVP on SportsCenter after the game. We know that much. 2-point game. Kentucky 2-0, beat Utah Valley by 10, trailed by as many as a dozen, and then held off Vermont 73-69 in their second game. A block by Gabriel.
Run, baby, run. I think that's going to be their key. Use their speed. Use their quickness. Diallo. Hamidou Diallo, baby. Watch this in transition. There's the steal. There he goes. Up, up, and away. Dunk City. Here he goes. He's going to Sports Center. He's going to Highlights Time.
With their length, they're gonna come up with a lot of steals, and they're going to block a lot of shots. Gabriel. Got it.
I tell you, Gabriel and Kilaway Jones give the positive minutes. Yep. That's a big plus for the Viper Dandies.
Timeout, Kansas, after this run by the Wildcats.
I think they could be a great pressing team, Kentucky. I think they got shot blockers back there with Richards. I think they could run a trap with Diallo, Green, and company. I really think they have the potential to have a dynamite pressure basketball team.
They've got five blocks and six steals in this game already, and it's a tie game at 28. Well, we saw the college football rankings show between the games. ABC College Football will bring you now number 3, Miami, as they are home to take on Virginia Saturday at noon Eastern, also streaming live on the ESPN app. I know you don't want to talk about Miami because Miami blew up Notre Dame, and that's a sore spot. How are you feeling about football right now?
Well, you know, right now I felt miserable. I was at that game sitting with a lot of Miami fans, and they had that swag big time, man. They put the hurt on the Irish, no doubt about it. They dominated every way. Now they're going to be careful. Virginia Tech could be a dangerous game for them. They had two big wins, Virginia Tech and the Fighting Irish in Notre Dame. Still, Alabama's going to win it all. Nick Saban.
Mazibuki draws the foul. Well, he is the inside presence tonight for Kansas.
I'm really impressed the way they regrouped after the early negative start, Kentucky, and got themselves to where they're right now, made this game even. He can coach. Anybody has a doubt that John Calipari can coach, go to watch a practice session. If they just think, I have people tell me, oh, he just recruits great players. Oh, really? Go watch him work in his office, which is his practice floor, and the guy is a workaholic and knows the game.
Four pretty special coaches in this event, wouldn't you say?
I think they're pretty good.
Not bad.
I think they're pretty good.
And these four programs, by the way, why are they here? The Champions Classic, they've combined for 18 national championships and 56 Final Fours.
This would be like a Final Four right here.
This would be a Final Four we could only dream of.
Yeah, unbelievable.
This is the seventh year of the Champions Classic, and it's locked in for at least the next two. Next year it'll be in Indianapolis, and then in 2019 it'll be in Madison Square Garden in New York City.
Got a little carry right there. I'm going to tell you, team, you keep your eyes on. Trust me, they are going to challenge the big guys big time.
I know who you're going to say.
Wichita State, the Shockers. They are for real.
Yeah.
I spoke up in Wichita about a week ago. I was with Greg Marshall, and I'm telling you, those 1,500 people over the crowd are excited about Shocker basketball.
Yeah, well, you're at Atlantis in the Bahamas. Mr. Billis and I will see Wichita State out in an hour.
Double it up McDuffie there, though.
Tip-in is good. The lead up to 4.
Both these teams really athletic. We talk about athletic, we talk speed, quickness, elevation. See, here's where they struggle, basically, the 5-5 situation.
Diallo left it short. You're right, they will score in transition. They will get some layups and dunks. How will they be in the half court?
You gotta make that play 5-on-5 and really control tempo of the game against them.
Great look for Neiman, long rebound to Graham. Boy, it is a battle on the glass. Bodies are flying.
And there's a lot of pride, man. You look at the new jerseys that stand for over 4,000 wins.
Yes. Number 1, Kentucky, 2,239. Number 2, Kansas, 2,218.
I knew you would have that. I knew I set you up beautiful. I threw a nice little fastball.
Assist Vital.
Making shots is tough for the final half-court game.
Yeah. Wayne Gabriel the foul. And and Kansas into the bonus at the other end.
Now, you were talking earlier about the improvement when you look at the certainly the SEC. I simply say, if I had to rate my conferences down, I would say, you know, this is preseason now we're talking. We have to let the games play out to get a real read. But right now, based on paper and what we see, I have ACC number one, Big Ten number two, SEC number three, Big East number four, Big 12 number five, Pac-12 number six.
All subject to change. Sure, as you say. Yeah. Knox drives the double team. Good ball movement.
Excellent ball movement. Reverse the ball, cut to each side.
Winyard back in. Jump hook, no.
Too hard.
And we have a timeout on the floor and an up and down affair. Number four, Kansas leading number seven to Kentucky. 32-28. The pace has been good. The intensity has been great. As these two blue bloods duke it out here in Chicago.
New red Mercedes convertible. And we're raffling it off. Only 1,500 chances. $100 per chance. All you got to do is go to DickVitaleOnline.com and you can donate $100 and get your chance. Can't win if you don't get a chance. And I simply want to also say, the best to Weston. He's a 9-year-old. You would love this kid, man. He had brain surgery yesterday on cancer. They removed the tumor. His mom told me today his recovery's been super in the 24 hours. Doctor's very optimistic. How good is he as an ice skater? This kid was a tremendous as a 9-year-old hockey player, and he's going to get back on the ice in about 6 to 8 weeks, the doctor said. He skated. I called John Cooper up. He's a great guy. He had him skate with the Lightning team.
Great kid.
Weston, we wish you the best, buddy.
Absolutely. Both these coaches have been involved in the game.
They're down there all the time on my gallery. We should be honoring Jim Harbaugh, Mike Greenberg, Greeny, and we're honoring also Leonard Hamilton.
Quade Green draws the foul.
That should be raised 3.1 million. This year, I hope to raise 3.5. So far, we raised 21 million for pediatric cancer. We got to help kids.
Green at the line for Kentucky. Coming up at the half, the Alfa Romeo halftime report. Reese, Seth, and Jay, a look at a career night for Grayson Allen. 37 points leading Duke to victory over Michigan State. A block party for Villanova tonight in reaction to the football playoff rankings.
Ice teasing and block. The room there, ESPN's room. Jason was sitting there, and I made believe I didn't know he was there. And I said, boy, find a dude's got a card that can score, man. He got a card that can score.
Two-point game.
Good first half. So a lot of athleticism. Not smooth, not well played, but we see a lot of toughness.
And again, for Kentucky, a team that started five freshmen. You know, to play in a game of this magnitude this early in the season. Wayne Gabriel just lost a shoe. He's trying to get it back on, and he did to a certain extent. Now the whistle blows with a foul against his teammate Winyard, so that will allow Gabriel to get that shoe back on.
Well, Winyard earned some playing time. He's playing these veteran players, getting some minutes.
Yeah. Well, they've got a little bit of foul trouble right now up front. Richards and Washington both had two, and neither has played since he picked up his second.
And our superstar statistician, Mr. Madre, gives me Kansas dominating the glass, 20-9. 20-9, 13 offensive rebounds. He's not blocking out. He's got to improve on the free throw line.
Knox from the elbow. Gets it to go, and it's tied.
Nice little medium range shot there. Get him involved. Get him the ball. He is a scorer. He's a number one option.
He's the high scorer in the game with a dozen.
His father was a heck of a football player at Florida State. Played in the NFL. Stay in front of him. You got to stay in front of him.
Georges Alexander did his job and comes up with the ball. He's got the length to recover a little bit, even when somebody gets by him, and he did there. Ooh, wow. Gabriel is going to lose that collision 100 times out of 100.
You know, early in the season, shot selection really becomes a problem. Many players, young players, don't understand the importance of a good shot. Whether you're challenged on a shot, you don't want to be in a situation where you're challenged on a lot of shots.
As I remember, Bucky Waters used to say when I watched him do games sometimes, sometimes you're the windshield and sometimes you're the bug. And Wenyen Gabriel was the bug right there.
That's
as he
right.
ran into Azubuike.
You know, Bucky's on the board of the V Foundation.
Gabriel, again, the most experienced player that Kentucky has coming back. He started 23 games but did not start late in the season, the last 6 weeks or so. But again, they bring back like 8% of their scoring, 12% of their minutes. Even by John Calipari Kentucky standards, this is an incredibly inexperienced team. But they're getting some experience here tonight.
Oh, nice backdoor cut. Great pass. Staring at the basketball. You got to watch Paul Newman. Great look.
And that first lead of the night for Kentucky only lasted a few seconds.
You know, what's really interesting, a game like this, you find out about strengths, you find out about weaknesses. Mm-hmm. There's so many cupcake cities out there right now. Popcorn City, Cupcake
Popcorn,
City.
Right. Coach Calipari says Popcorn City.
Popcorn City.
Knox.
Knox is going to drive the basketball in the board. Not just want to be a jump shooter.
I'll tell you, Garrett's a really good rebounder for a guard. He had 10 in their win over Tennessee State. That was a strong board right there. Graham again.
That's not a good shot right there. See, that's not a good shot. A veteran player being challenged on his shot, 23 feet away, not a good shot. Now, he's got a license to shoot anytime he wants now, being the star. But you got to understand, good shot. I'm surprised the kid Jackson, who's the star of the game last year between these two teams, is not doing better in the NBA. I thought he was going to be an instant star.
And a foul away from the ball. Diallo back into the game, and Kalia Jones as well for Kentucky. They are deeper tonight than Kansas. Again, the Jayhawks only with 7 available scholarship players. Billy pressed in the 8th, assuming that he is cleared at some point, and then maybe D'Souza second semester. But even that, even if both of those things happen, they've only got 9 scholarship players on this team.
Well, they got another kid sitting out as well, who will be eligible, transfer from Arizona
You're
State.
Right, Sam Cutler from Arizona State. So, yeah, and he'll be eligible in December. And they got some good players sitting out who are going to play for them next year. Huh?
Well, the two transfers from Memphis. The brothers who also.
Yeah, also Charlie Moore from Cal. Into the final minute of the first half. Graham Nola pass. Newman rises up for a 3. Nice tip out by Garrett.
Boy, they're killing on the offensive boards. You look at the stat sheet. John Calipari's not going to be happy looking at that stat sheet. Look at him on the sideline. He's animated there.
Isn't that the worst when the guys on the bench get blamed for something that the guys on the court did?
Brian's trying to use that as a teaching lesson about blocking out.
16 on the shot clock for Kansas.
You know, what makes the 4 coaches here today so special? They're all about the moment. They're not all about our records, Hall of Fame. They're about tonight. They want to leave here with a W.
Kentucky's 4-2 in the history of this event. Kansas 2-4. And Kentucky can hold for the last shot, maybe get into the locker room with the lead.
See, if I'm Kansas now, Bill Self, he can't be pleased with some of the shot selection by his club.
Diallo into a lot of traffic, too strong off the glass. And the first half comes to a close.
If I were Diallo, I would spend hour after hour in the gym and work on my jump shot, because if he can get that to be part of his athleticism, he's going to make a lot of money.
Number 4, Kansas leading. Number 7, Kentucky by a single point at halftime. 34-33. And Maria is with John Calipari.
All right, Coach, you did have one lead in this game. What has allowed you to work efficiently on the offensive end?
We have absolutely no chance of winning this game. I think they have 18 points on second shots. And my guys act like they want to we want to win. No, you don't want to win, or you would rebound these balls. And Kansas is out hustling us. But I'll say this, really proud of a bunch of Frenchmen. Might have your arm really hard.
It's really tight. I'm not your player. What about transition offense? Are you playing to the tempo that you want to be playing in this game right
now? Not bad. I mean, you know, we had a couple turnovers unforced, but look, I'm proud of my guys. I mean, I'm trying to be positive, but when they're getting rebounds and out-hustling us for 50-50 balls, normally my head pops off. Right now it stayed on my shoulders, but I'm proud of them. Playing good.
All right, thanks for your time.
Well, he's telling a true story. Offensive rebounds 15 for Kansas for 15 second chance points. Jayhawks lead by one. After the break, the Alfa Romeo Halftime Report with Reese, Jay, and the coach. Young Kentucky in a matchup like this against a more experienced Kansas team.
Well, you know, I thought Kansas really did a great job on the boards. They didn't shoot the ball exceptionally well, but I think that can be negated in the second half. Think about this. Washington and Richards, the two big guys, were on the sideline with two fouls. They'll be back on the floor right now, so that should help them in terms of rebounding. That was a difference maker. However, I like the toughness of Kentucky. I like the fact that Knox got free to make shots. He's an offensive player who they got to get the ball to. They're going to take advantage of his multi-skills on the offensive end.
Yeah, he really had a nice shot. Nice first half, made some outside shots. Let's go cross-court now. Maria Taylor's got an update.
Well, Dan, Bill Self coming out of the locker room saying that he looked at that field goal percentage and said it's simply shot selection. They're not doing a good job choosing good shots on the floor. He wants to see his team putting the ball on the deck, getting to the rim, and not settling as much for threes. He also mentioned that Devontae Graham, he feels like he's pressing just a little bit, shooting 3-for-10 in that first half.
All right, Maria, thank you. 34-33, Kansas over Kentucky. Knox who inbounds it with a game-high 12. We are ready for the tip of our Sonic blockbuster matchup. Kansas in white, Kentucky in blue. Remember the Jayhawks with only 7 available scholarship players. Mikhailu had to sit for a while in the first half because he picked up a couple of fouls. And Kwadwo Green again gets the start at the point in the second half, although Gilgeous Alexander gave him some good minutes off the bench. Green the kick, knocks the three. Kansas ball.
He was challenged on that shot. A young kid has to learn what is a good shot. The definition of a good shot.
Is this one a good shot? Graham with a deep one. Comes up empty and then almost picked it off. Washington, nice feed to Knox.
Great look by Washington. Tremendous vision. Knox running the court. Comes down the gut of the defense. Good two-man play by the two type of dandies.
And Knox now with a 14. Graham looking inside. They're going into the big foul as a bookie.
That was a great entry right there by Devontae Graham. Tremendous look inside. What a dynamite perimeter game they had last year. Mason Graham and Jackson, yep. They were terrific that threesome.
And even though Mikhailu played a lot and plays a lot at the four spot, he's a perimeter guy too. He's really an outside shooter. Double team on Washington. Turns it over. And a foul committed by Diallo.
Really bad pass right here. Good anticipation. Here's the double up. Tries to reverse the ball. Steps in the passing lane. Makes like a defensive back. Great deflection.
Well, let's see if Kansas tries to go right back inside to Azubuki. Not really known as a scorer. But he's just so big in there.
Impossible shot. The angle was impossible.
And they're outnumbered at the other end. What a finish by Diallo.
Diallo's such an athlete. There aren't many guys that have his athletic ability on this collegiate level, I'll tell you that. They got to utilize that transition game. Force turnovers and get up and down the court.
Newman misses a three.
They got to push the ball, put pressure on the defenses.
Diallo into the body of Azubuki. Nobody helping out on the glass for Kansas, though. And against Kentucky, another opportunity.
But Diallo right there should have had Richards for a layup. With one little extra pass, they had themselves a layup. You're going to see the little lob up on top. Watch the catch. This is a terrific catch. Not an easy play right there. That is not an easy play.
I mean, the dunk from the first half will be all over SportsCenter. This might be a harder play than
he made. That was a tough play right there. Out of agility.
Diallo, the redshirt freshman from Queens, New York.
I saw him play up in high school over in Fort Myers, and I was really impressed. Everybody was looking at him. Then he decided, good rebound right there. Oh, what a nice little pass.
Little turnover, and back comes KU. And Richards holding Azubuike, and now gets called for the foul. That'll be the third on Richards. He's given up 40, 50 pounds. About 40 pounds down to the post trying to stay with Azubuike. He'll go out, and now Kalia Jones will come in. And if he gets Azubuike, he's given up 60 pounds. 220 against 280.
Bottom line is they better get in the kitchen and start eating.
Well, or start lifting. Which they are, you know they are. But I mean, Azubuike's just a mountain of a man. He's huge. Mikhailuk with a couple of crossovers. And misses the left-handed runner.
That was a real good drive right there. He just didn't finish the play. They came up and challenged him because they know he can shoot the three. And made him put the ball on the floor.
Baseline floater Diallo and an offensive foul. Third on Diallo.
I'll tell you, Dan, watching them tonight, both these clubs, they are really minus the outstanding talents they had last year. We don't realize it. People say, well, they got other great freshmen stepping in. But the loss of people like Mason and Jackson, the loss of people like we think from Kentucky with the Aaron Fox and Malik Monk and Adebayo, those are major, major players. Those are NBA players.
Right, and if and when Kansas gets Preston, that helps. If they get D'Souza, when they get Conlett there, their team will change. Mikhailuk for three. And a name we haven't mentioned yet for Kentucky is Jared Vanderbilt. Right, terrific freshman from Houston is out with a foot injury, and they're hoping to get him back at least practicing within a couple of weeks.
They have another youngster by the glass. Good offensive rebound right there.
Kalia Jones.
Yep, he's going to get some minutes.
Graham the kick. Mikhailuk, nice fake, nice dish. Vic short on the three.
I tell you, Vanderbilt's a very star player, multi-dimensional. Got another kid, Baker, who can shoot the ball. Not a great athlete, but can shoot the ball. They don't know when they can get him back. Maybe January. I was talking to Jerry Tipton and John Clay before the game. The guys are following Kentucky religiously. And they said they're not sure yet when he will be available.
Double team again on Washington. Force him to give it up. Shot clock at five. Knox trying to create, turns it over.
Help defense stepped right in and took that drive on. Look at that quickness. But you got to be under control.
Yeah, no numbers there for Newman.
You got to understand what is a good shot. There's no chance to make that play happen.
Kalia Jones with a drive. And he lost control, but it'll stay with Kentucky. Timeout on the floor here early in the second half. The Wildcats lead by one.
Falcons, Seahawks, Monday, 8:15 Eastern on ESPN.
I wait to share Thanksgiving down there at the Atlantis. That's one of the great places. My grandchildren love that place. Got all those swimming pools. Except, you know, if I put my bathing suit on, I think Blake Shelton will be in trouble as the sexiest man in the nation picked by People Magazine. Oh, wow. He'll be in trouble.
I don't see it that way. Out of bounds, and it's going to Kansas.
Tell you one thing, rebounding here in the second half, it's been a difference from the first half. 9-1, Kentucky. Unbelievable.
Total reversal. What you said with Washington Richards back in the game, although Richards picked up his third, so he went to the bench.
You were listening to me. Thank you. I appreciate that. Wow. Yeah, I felt that they would make a difference. You know, John Calipari got a little over them at halftime about that. I think with Kansas, understanding what a good shot is, that's the one emphasis I think Bill Self's going to put on these players. Especially with veteran guys like Graham and Mikhailuk. Good spacing right there.
Garrett's open for three. Got it.
Nice. Get a player from off the bench. They say he does all the little things. That's the scouting report on him.
First points of the night for Marcus Garrett, the freshman from Dallas.
They did a tremendous job there. Good spacing, good ball movement as well.
Lee Jones the screen, trying to free up Gilgeous Alexander. Gabriel for three. Tip back out by Knox. There's the length that Kentucky has.
Nice play by Knox to make that happen, to give him a second opportunity.
What a green.
Challenge. That not a good shot right there. Challenge on that shot.
Will they be a good three-point shooting team? The results are mixed in the early going.
I really think that's going to be a struggle for them.
Graham, nice handoff. And Azubuike fouled by Gabriel. I don't know that Azubuike was expecting to get that pass, or he probably would have been able to get up there and dunk it without getting fouled.
You know, you mentioned them shooting the three there. I really believe their strength's got to be their ability to utilize their athleticism, to force turnovers, and to get up in transition. Look at this play right here.
And a hard foul by Gabriel. So he's got three. Diallo's got three. Richards has three.
Azubuike did not look really comfortable shooting free throws earlier in this game. He's praying for that bounce. Yep.
Last year, in 11 games before the season-ending injury, he was a 38% free throw shooter.
Becomes really mental to you, too. You practice. I'm sure they got him in the gym constantly working on it.
And he'll get fouled a lot. He'll get opportunities. Again, he's not a naturally gifted scorer. He's more of a presence at the other end, but he's just 3 for 7 now from the line and out.
Well, you're late in the game. It's tough to play him because, you know, teams are going to put him on a free throw line late in the game.
Washington, assertive move, too strong. And it's Kansas ball.
I'll tell you one thing. Have you seen an example here of really a pure shooter? Every shot seems to be
for Kentucky.
Seems a lot of bricks, yep, other than Kevin Knox. And I would call him pure. I call him a scorer. He can't shoot the ball.
He's the only Kentucky player to make a three tonight. He's 3 for 5. The rest of his teammates are 0 for 5.
John's going to work a lot of time, a lot of shooting drills, because that's going to be really important.
Whoa. Looks like it's very, very lucky that both of those guys are okay, Vic and Gilgeous Alexander. That could have ended a lot worse for both guys.
Yeah. Little fake. See, a lot of guys really out of control here tonight. Wow.
First foul on Gilgeous Alexander. Knox, step back, dump off Washington,
nice play.
Inside for Jones.
Oh, you got a score. That was a great play, but you got a score.
But a foul call.
And look, opposite. I'll tell you what, the Big Blue Nation fans, I was having breakfast the other day, a couple come over to me and said, gee whiz, what's wrong with our Kentucky team? They struggled with Vermont. I said, give me a break. Vermont won 29 games. They got 4 starters back.
Yep.
They want instant greatness right away. That's one place, man. You're not going to lose games.
Passionate, demanding, right? Big Blue Nation. Remember, we did game day there a bunch of years ago. They had 22,000. They filled Rupp for game day.
They're unbelievable. Yep. They're fast. Love, eat, sleep, and drink Kentucky basketball.
Knox another offensive rebound.
Well, they've done a better job in that area than they did in the first half. We haven't seen the zone at all. I thought we were going to see some zone.
That's going to count.
Tell you one thing, they got some athletes, though. They really do. See, I have a reason why they are not excellent shooters. You want to hear it?
Yes.
I'm going to tell you why. These kids are so quick and so explosive and so talented on the high school scholastic level. They can beat anybody off the bounce anytime they wanted, get to the rim, score, and never really had to work hard on shooting the basketball. And I really believe many of them can improve, because now that's an area they must improve if they want to elevate their game.
The old-fashioned three-point play, Kentucky back on top. as the lead continues to trade hands. Newman, shovel pass, Mikhailuk. Kansas has the lead.
I really like him. I really like Mikhailuk. He knows how to play. He knows how to come off that pass to get free for the shot. A lot of guys don't know how to get free to utilize their shot.
He's the high scorer for Kansas tonight with 13, and now an errant pass. Newman trying to do it himself, rejected. Again, second time this half, he's gone to the rim or tried to without having the numbers. Now,
oh, they had a layup. Look at a sloppy play.
It's hot potato. Oh. Knox. Oh. Well, that was something. And Kansas had an easy layup. Asabuki and Winyard really banging down at the other end inside.
I love that little weave. You can jump switch up on top.
Graham spinning, dishing, and it'll stay with Kansas.
Devontae Graham hasn't had the kind of game that you would anticipate for a senior and a leader and a talented player of his ability.
But another senior for Kansas, Vyacheslav Mikhailuk, the high scorer for the Jayhawks tonight with 13 in his two. Diallo with a dozen tonight, Knox with 14. Mikhailuk leads Kansas with 13. Two-point lead, KU. Let's check in with Maria.
Bill Self telling his team that he wants to see Asabuki getting more touches inside. And it was a really simple message. He's bigger than everybody else, guys. Give him a look right now.
Yeah, it's been a pretty good formula for them, yeah. Maria. Thank you very much, because he's been able to get to the line, not necessarily convert, but get to the line. There's a turnover by Kansas on an inbounds play. Miscommunication between Graham and Vic. You don't expect that, and that's the 10th turnover committed by the Jayhawks tonight.
Well, you know, we'd be up to realize also, we're talking about the middle of November. I mean, these guys have not been in the gym that often together, playing game situation, playing against this kind of caliber, both in clubs, a lot of talent. Sloppy play.
Yeah, a lot of turnovers here the last few minutes.
Execution efficiency is really not there.
Vic, step back jumper.
They're going to make some of those shots. That's their strength. Kansas' strength is shooting the basketball with their quartet of people on the perimeter. Whether it be Newman, whether it be Graham, whether it be Kylo, or certainly Vic.
Diallo draws the foul on Newman.
There's no doubt about it. Newman's got to play better defense if he wants to play in that Kansas uniform. I mean, he was not in a good defensive stance. He bumped the guy.
Mikhailuk back into the game and out for Kansas, and Richards back in for Kentucky. You get the feeling Bill Self feels he's going to get more out of Newman, you're talking about,
absolutely,
than he's getting right now. He's still getting acclimated.
He's so talented. In high school, he was as good as it gets.
And Jaren Tallard, one of the assistants for Kansas, recruited him hard, but he decided to stay home, go to Mississippi State. But once he decided to transfer, quickly reconnected with Howell and decided to come to Lawrence. Shot clock at two.
Kentucky wanted him also.
Wow. Soft rim, soft touch for Gilgeous Alexander.
I think he's got a lot more PT playing time. Yeah. I really do. He's got that size. I think we're going to see Kentucky this year utilize that 2-3 zone with those two big guards. Right now, he wants them to have a ton of ability.
Mikhailuk a little bit short. Rebound, Kentucky with a chance to tie or take the lead. We got a foul going against Kansas to put a stop to the action. A reminder that tomorrow night on ESPN, got an NBA doubleheader coming your way. LeBron of the Cavs taking on the Hornets in the early game at 8 o'clock Eastern time. And then the Sixers, led by former Jayhawk Joel Embiid, they took on the Lakers in game two.
Wow, he was unbelievable last night. He had like 32, I think something like 14. Terrific down. He just got to stay away from the injury bug. Cavaliers, they cannot win unless they get Isaiah Thomas to give them the kind of scoring that Irving gave them last year to help out LeBron. LeBron can't do all the scoring by himself.
Richards with a bad pass.
Oh, that's there's a good pass. One. That's a good pass right there. Man, that's a good pass. That was a Tom Brady pass to Gronkowski. Oh, there's a little battle going on.
Ball never touched the floor for Kansas.
That's how you want your kids to run the transition. That's a foul. That's a foul. That's a foul. He looks at us.
He didn't like it. He's trying to get a little sympathy from here.
Sympathy, Devontae.
How about this pass by LeGerald Vick? Can he play football?
Tom Brady, baby. There it is, the bump. Might have taken an extra step, but they'll get away with that in the NBA. He got away with one here. He got away with one. Pretty good for a guy with one eye. I could see that.
Richards just took too long to start making his move, and that's another Kentucky turnover.
John Calipari is going to earn that big check he's getting. And it is big. It is big. Way bigger than it was at Massachusetts. He makes more in a month than he made there in 3 years.
15 turnovers, and he's bringing in 3 subs. He's not happy with what he's seeing from his young tests. Long finish.
Oh, Ragnar Azubuike. Get a T.O., Mr. Calipari. Get a T.O. He didn't like what he's seen there in that two-man game. The two-man game. Oh, great execution right there, Dan. There, nobody rotates over. There's no communication. You got to communicate. Let me tell you this. There are 3 things you must do, Dan, if you want to have a legitimate big-time team and win. Number 1, players have to understand shot selection. Number 2, you have to defend as a team. Communicate, which was lacking here. The ability to communicate with one another, to help to one another, and to block out. And number 3, you got to rebound the basketball. You do those 3 things, you are an elite team, and you're going to win. You're going to win your share of games.
Kentucky, as you can see, 5 turnovers in the last 3 minutes and 53 seconds. 16 turnovers on the night.
See, I think that Knox drifts away from the action too much. He's too talented. He's got to be more aggressive in wanting the basketball. See, he's standing too stationary.
Diallo short.
Easy to guard a guy. A guy that's stationary is easy to guard. You got to move without the ball, run people off screens to want the ball.
As you said before, it's November. So much can change between now and February, March, especially for a team as young as Kentucky. Garrett the drive, some contact, and there is a foul call. I think the baseline official, Roger Ayers, was screened out by the bodies, but Joe DeRosa saw it up top.
You know, we talked about danger time. I think right now we're starting to approach that for Kentucky. I really do. I think it's a little danger period. They got to step it up right now and come back with a little spurt.
John Calipari made 3 substitutions at the last time out. He was not a happy guy.
I got too easy a layup. There's no communication, a little screen. John can coach. There's no doubt about it.
Knox trying to stay with Graham. Azubuike. Graham. Pretty good look. Couldn't knock it down. Here come the cats. Green. Reverse.
Tremendous play by Green right there. Quadre Green from out of Philadelphia. Big time recruit. A lot of people wanted him. Has a lot of potential. He's got to learn how to stay in front of that basketball and not get beat off the bounce.
6 points now for Green, who admits he's just not used to playing at this fast of a pace. He just played at a more methodical, deliberate pace, but he's picking up the pace because his coach is telling him to.
Well, you know, I'll give you another point with a lot of these guys. They're such star players, they don't have to elevate that like game or put that intensity on a high school level.
Hard foul there by Azubuike. Didn't want to give Diallo a bucket. And Diallo will have to earn it at the line. When we come back, Kansas leading Kentucky by 4.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by State Farm. Talk to an agent today at 800-STATE-FARM.
4-point lead on the Wildcats, 7:37 to go after Duke defeated Michigan State 88-81. In the first game here tonight. Coaches are into it. It may be November, but there's March intensity. Coming up after this game tonight, SportsCenter with SVP. A look back at the first game and a second. Look back at both games here from Chicago. An interview to the newest star in Philly. That's Ben Simmons. And Kenny Mayne meets Aaron Rodgers in the end zone. Packers picking up a big road win at Chicago behind Brett Hundley on the weekend.
Hey, one thing Scott Van Pelt does a great job with that shot with Ben Simmons. He's shooting the ball a lot better than people thought, and it looks like he's going to be tough to beat for Rookie of the Year. He's been terrific early in the season.
So Diallo at the line for Kentucky after that hard foul by Azubuike.
See, I think the toughest thing coaches have to do with these young kids that come out of high school, they're so talented that many of them develop bad habits defensively because they don't have to assert themselves and do all the things you have to do once you get to this level and you meet the quickness and the talent you have to face here. So it takes a little time to break them from those bad habits. You see a look at Bill Self and you see John Calipari on that sideline. You would think they never won a game. You would think these guys are fighting for coaching survival. I think their jobs are pretty safe.
That's what makes them so good. I mean,
exactly.
Israel and Krzyzewski the same way?
Absolutely. Players have that fear of failure with those guys. You don't want to fail, man.
Four Hall of Famers here.
Credibility.
At the Champions Classic. And now, Quade Green called for the foul for Kentucky. It'll be the sixth team foul on the Wildcats. So the next one will send Kansas to the line. Kansas is already over the limit.
Tell you, we need to mention Alabama. We took the SEC. They're going to be pretty good. Colin Sexton is a tremendous talent. He's eligible today.
League will be strong. Texas A&M with a big win over West Virginia in the Armed Forces Classic.
Without Robert Williams and without Kid Caldwell.
Yeah.
He pushed off. He pushed off. Don't get me started about the FBI report, because I get started there, I'm not going to stop. That sleaziness, when coaches can sell kids, for money to agents, how do they sleep at night? The guys that were arrested who did that, that blows my mind. Sleaziness. No place for us.
Only time will tell whether we've seen most of what we're going to find out or whether there's a whole other layer coming.
Well, I just think that the one thing, based on the facts and records, I mean, it's not a rumor. I mean, head down there, person there, Auburn, $91,000. Don't get me going on that. That sleaziness really bothers me.
Two-point game. Kansas with the ball in the lead, 7 minutes to go. Azubuike. The basket will not count. The foul before the shot. And it'll be on Kalia Jones.
And those self-trucking Roger Ayers right there. They did a great job, though, Kansas, spreading the court and trying to get a little one-on-one on the inside and lob the ball up on top. They want to get him involved offensively.
And as Maria said in her report a few minutes ago, Bill Self telling his team in the huddle, keep getting it inside him. They don't have anybody nearly as big as Azubuike is.
I'll tell you this. I'll put him on a free throw line like they did right here.
Yeah.
Because it's been a mystery. His journey to that free throw line has been an absolute mystery.
3 for 7 tonight.
It's back to his average of last year, 37%.
Yep.
3 for 8.
That's pretty good. That old math teacher is coming out again.
Sixth grade,
huh?
Man. Yeah.
Jumper is good for Kalia Jones to tie it.
See, I think Kalia Jones is going to get some really good minutes because he can make shots. He can make shots. You saw that form right there. Nice touch. Nothing but nylon NBN.
Vic elevates and hits. Boy, he can make some tough shots.
Oh, he's acrobatic. He really is so quick, explosive. He just has to learn to play under control and utilize his speed in a positive way.
Very limited bench for Kansas with Preston out again. Lightfoot's only played 4 minutes, so basically they've been using six guys as Knox ties it up for UK.
Well, Knox drove down the lane a little bit there, got stopped, but still converted. He has to do more of that, using driving ability.
Azubuike again. They're going to keep going to it until Kentucky finds a way to stop it.
They're spreading the court and dumping it on the interior. See, I wouldn't let him score down there. Foul him. Put him on the line. Put him on the line. Hack a shot.
Kentucky's got four guys with three fouls, but under 6 minutes to go. They can afford to foul him a little bit. Diallo baseline. Good D there by Newman.
Get it to Knox. He's got to go to the left a little more.
Gilgeous Alexander, nowhere to go. Knox, 17-footer, yes.
Go to Knox. Go to Knox.
Trading buckets, Dickie B, tied at 55.
Oh, yeah, Kansas, Kentucky, early in the season, over 4,000 wins. Number one, number two all-time winners. It can't get better than this. Get the goosebumps, baby.
Graham, though. Graham having a tough shooting night.
He has had a tough night. in many ways.
Diallo shuttle pass. Rejection as a bookie.
Get it to Knox. He's going to want the ball. He's going to post. He's got size up right now. He's got size up, Vic. He's throwing side. He's drifting to the wing here.
Really more of a perimeter face-up guy.
He can post. I've seen him do it.
Washington post. Kick. Gilgeous Alexander. Air ball. Well, he had a more open shot than the one he ended up taking.
I got the opportunity to offensive rebound, doing a lot better job rebounding the basketball.
And Bill Self wants a timeout.
Well, we got a good one, Dan. Mr. Schulman, we got a good one.
Yep. Two teams with high hopes, definitely both a work in progress at this point of the season, but we're just in week two.
They're going to win a lot of games, there's no doubt about it.
All right, let's take a look at some of the things that Kevin Knox has done tonight. He's the game high scorer with 18.
He gave him a real spurt in the beginning. There he is right here with Schulman jump shot. He made three big threes in the first half. There's another one. Show that stroke from out of Tampa, Florida. I want to see him drive the basketball more. Post up, go inside, utilize his talent. He's got more talent than just being a jump shooter.
He is still the only Kentucky player tonight to hit a three. He's got all three of their threes.
Tell you one thing, there'll be no quit in those kids. Both those uniforms, there'll be no quit. Those two Hall of Famers will not tolerate it. And they're going to play their way. Hard, tough. They may not show a great efficiency and effectiveness, but they're going to play hard.
Yep. And Kentucky with five freshmen again on the floor. They started that way, not this particular group, but they started with five freshmen. And for much of the night, they've had five freshmen in there. We've seen a little of Gabriel, a little of Kalia Jones, a little of Winyard, but the freshmen getting a ton of time.
I've often said the formula for success is talent plus coaching equals W-win.
A little experience doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt at all. If you got talent, that's experience. Like Grayson Allen was, he was unbelievable in that first game.
37 points leading Duke to a victory.
And they did it all because Bagley was out of the lineup the second half.
Oh, what a steal. Vic.
Oh, got to lay it on the backboard. Lay it on the backboard. All that speed, quickness, athleticism.
Double team again. They want to get Washington to give it up every time. Green with a floater, no. Follow, yes. Richards.
Nice rebound by Richards, who played at the same high school as Michael Gilchrist, one of my favorite college players. He defended, he rebounded. That team was special. Anthony Davis and company, that was a special team.
Let's see how Kansas responds. Corner three, not there. Vic gets it back. Mikhailuk ties the game.
He's a veteran player. He understands how to play. Mikhailuk understands how to play. He knows what a good shot is.
He's played with and behind some very good players in his time at Kansas, but he's taking on a much larger role this year.
Absolutely. He'll be one of their star players this season. There's no doubt about it.
And Washington the foul.
It's four for him, isn't it?
Less than 3 minutes to go here in regulation at the United Center in Chicago. And back and forth they go. Nick Richards gives Kentucky the lead. Kansas feeding a bucket at the other end, and they turn to a senior, Steve Mikhailuk, tying it up.
The sub above difference is grilled. Because if you're making a cheesesteak and you're not using a hot grill to make...
Tomorrow on ESPN.
Fresh off their demolition of Notre Dame, undefeated, and now number 3, Miami. He's home again at Hard Rock Stadium to take on Virginia Saturday at noon Eastern on ABC and also streaming live on the ESPN app. Game show on the Dick Vitale, Maria Taylor. 2:53 to go in regulation. The number 4, Kansas, number 7, Kentucky, are tied at 57. There's been a rebound turnaround here in the second half tonight.
And they did a great job in the second half rebounding. We got Richards on the floor, Washington. They were in foul trouble, utilized their size. I really think this game comes down right now the last 3 minutes, the free throw line. Who's going to make shots at the charity stripe is going to leave here with a W.
Well, Graham, a good guy to have at the line with the Kansas. He's not shot the ball well from the field tonight, but he's a good free throw shooter.
He had a terrific year last year. Had a play in the shadow of Frank Mason, who won every award possible.
I mean, we talked a lot about what Kentucky lost, and they lost almost everything. Kansas lost National Player of the Year, Frank Mason, and a lottery ticket, Josh Jackson.
Yeah, absolutely.
Lucas, very good, you know, very useful player as well.
Jackson went number four to Phoenix. He'll eventually be a good NBA player. He's just too talented.
Green. Not sure if that was a shot or a lob attempt to one of his teammates, but either way, it's Kansas ball.
Oh, he shot that basketball. You know, you come down the stretch right now, you get a little edge to Kansas because of the experience in the backcourt. I mean, Vic and certainly when you talk about Grant, they're so experienced.
Vic follows up his own miss.
What great legs, huh? What a bounce off the floor.
Newman wide open. Got it.
He can shoot the ball. That's the one out of here. Coach has given him a lot of trust right now, putting him on the floor at crunch time. This is the time. John Calipari said, I'm going to figure out who's our go-to guys and who's going to be on the floor when the game's on the line.
John Calipari's got to be going crazy that Vic got his own miss back and kicked it out that way to the three.
Yeah, you can't let a guard on the inside get that second opportunity like that. And then Newman delivered. Now he's got a guard. He can't stop worrying about celebrating. Got a guard. Got to get on defense.
Well, my friend.
It's been a lot of fun,
What have you learned tonight about these four teams?
Well, I learned they had some talent. Obviously, Duke, very talented. To win as they did without Bagley, very impressive. And I've said before the game started, I put them on Twitter, I said, Grayson Allen's going to have a big, big year. And he is. I think he's learned. I think he's matured. The stupidity, the immaturity that he was involved in. And Coach K, I'm telling you right now, he's got a nice complement of freshmen. Those kids, Trent, when you talk about Carter.
Duval had a strong game.
Duval is outstanding talent. He just got to work a little more shooting, but he's an outstanding talent from out of IMG. Michigan State's going to be very good. They're going to have a big time here.
Looking inside, Knox gets it to go.
Nice play. See, I like that on Knox. Moved without the ball, got the ball inside. Great call by John Calipari to get him the rock.
Yeah, the freshman's got 20 to make it a two-point game. Here comes the weave.
Now you got that experience on the perimeter. With Graham, McKyler.
Fading away, left it short.
Now you got a patience right here. Here's where you need leadership and you need patience.
Gilgeous Alexander with a point right now for UK.
Well, that's really a big plus for Alexander right now. The Coach Cal believes in him playing at the end of the game.
Rotating him and Green most of the night. Shot clock inside 10.
Oh, the deflection.
Shot clock at 5. They got to get going here. The shot is no good by Gilgeous Alexander, and Kansas, now as we enter the final minute, they can run a little clock here, take their time, and try to get a good look.
Yeah, they're going to manage the clock, spread the court, take time. You got to stop. Right now, you need a containment. You got to get a stop if you're Kentucky.
And will the experience of Kansas pay off here in the final seconds?
Well, here's where you expect guys like Graham or Vic.
One to shoot. And it is Kentucky ball. Washington got a piece of it.
Terrific defensive job by Kentucky. They did a fantastic job in that possession. And now they have the opportunity to tie this game up or take the lead.
Now here's what maybe they don't even know about themselves, much less we don't know it about them. Crunch time. Who's the go? What's
it's
the go-to play?
Gotta it's
be Knox. But what are you looking for? A drive, a shot. What do you want?
Well, you might want to move without the ball a little bit if you can. But he can make that 15-foot shot.
I think the officials are going to the clock to see exactly how much time should be left on the clock after the shot clock violation. 10 ties and 12 lead changes in this game tonight here in Chicago. A pretty good night of basketball.
It really is. This is the kind of games that you learn a lot about your team. You don't learn as much when you're beating teams 98-31. See some of their scores. A little surprised tonight. Liberty beat Wake Forest. I was surprised. Indiana State when they beat Indiana was a surprise to me.
Well, it looked like it's pretty much dead on at 33-6 when it went to zero, but the officials are having a look. They want to get it exact.
Yeah, want to make sure. Coming down the wire now. That's what the replay's there for. Get it right. And they decide 0.1 seconds to kick off.
I'll tell you that the battle between the fan bases is almost as good as the battle on the court here tonight.
Yeah, they really do. They travel. These people love their basketball. Rock Chalk, Jayhawk Land, great place. Allen Fieldhouse, rough is always like unreal. You go down, you can feel the enthusiasm, the energy. If I'm Kansas now, I got to think about Knox. I got to get my best defender on him.
And they've got Vic on Knox right now.
Well, Vic's a very athletic player.
Knox has it.
He's driving. Gets Vermont.
Tough shot from the baseline. Won't go. Ball's loose. And it belongs to Kansas.
The foul makes these foul shots. They'll be in pretty good shape.
That's still a ways to go. 17 seconds. It's 1-1. Still a ways to go.
Take a look right here. He's got a little one-on-one move. He wants a little baseline jump shot. Bad angle. Really not a good angle there to shoot that ball.
So Newman to the line now for Kansas has not been there tonight.
Whoa, whoa. He squeezed that baby in. He squeezed that baby in. He squeezed it in. He gave up big though with that big jumper he hit a moment earlier.
4-point game.
4 big points by Newman. You got to run up and score right away.
Diallo. Great rebound by Kalia Jones, and he gets it back down to 2. Timeout, Kentucky.
That was a terrific offensive rebound. I think Kalia Jones is going to earn himself some playing time.
You could envision this team developing into a very good offensive rebounding team with all the length, second chance opportunities.
I think they're going to have to work a little more on defensive pressure to utilize their athleticism, force turnovers. They're athletic, they're long. I mean, obviously, this is not as talented as a team they had in the basket. No. De'Aaron Fox, a bunch, were such special players in Adebayo.
Right.
Oh, wow. Wow. He got banged, didn't he?
So Kansas has the ball, 8 seconds left, up by 2. And if Kentucky doesn't get an immediate steal, they're going to foul right away. Wilson misses on the line.
That hasn't changed in years. The same strategic analysis. Try to steal. If they don't get it, right, bang, right. Knock them down. And put them on the line.
And if you're Bill Self, your first choice is get the ball into the hands of Devontae Graham. Let him make a good decision. Let him get fouled if they're going to foul anybody. Graham shot 73% from the line last year. Gerald Vick shot 83% from the line. You got 2 experienced guys in the backcourt.
Well, Mikhailo as well.
Yep.
That is their strength. Their strength is their perimeter game. 13 consecutive Big 12 titles. This is mind-boggling. They win it again this year, and I tell you, the conference is not as strong. They can tell me all they want. From top to bottom, it's not what it's been in the past. They can go 14 years in a row. It's unreal. Unreal.
Azubuike not in the game.
Not surprised.
Right, they don't want him and the free throw shooting issues in the game right now.
That's coaching. People wonder what coaches do.
And it's great. So they get it to the guy they want to get it to.
And he's got that stuff. I like the way he's working in the free throw line. Confidence, going up there with a lot of confidence. He's going to give 5s to his teammates. So give me the rock down. I'm going to show you why I'm the senior. I'm going to show you why I'm the leader. I'm going to show you why I'm a winner. And he's going to show me how I can go to bed and go to sleep late at night. This is past my bedtime. I'm going to get my oatmeal and get tucked in bed.
2 shots coming. Double bonus.
Nothing but nylon. You see the confidence. I like that in a player. You stroll to the line, your shoulders square to the rim, you got your head up. He makes this, party's over.
Yeah, no timeouts for Kentucky.
But Kentucky's going to win a lot of games. I'm telling you, this team has got a lot of athletes, toughness. They're just going to work on shooting the ball and finding out who they're going to rotate and who's going to play.
Georges Alexander forces up a three, and Kansas will win it. The Jayhawks prevail after losing on their two previous matchups to Kentucky here to the Champions Classic. They beat Kentucky tonight 65-61 in a game that certainly gives both coaches a lot to think about and a lot to work on going forward.
Yeah, they really do. They're going to work on certainly being more efficient, but that's going to come. It's so early in the season. And all you big Blue Nation fans, don't get down. Relax. Relax. It's a long year. It's a, you know, right now, it's not a sprint. It's a marathon, man. You got to be patient. Yep. Some of those fans are not patient. I can see right now on Twitter, we're not as good. They're not overrated. Relax.
So Duke beats Michigan State 88-81 in the first game tonight, and Kansas prevails over Kentucky.